I wish to introduce to you Colonel Bill McConnell, U.S. Air Force, retired. Please welcome him.
Thank you. Welcome again. I love you. I've been told I'm going to be shot in the back if I'm not done in 5 minutes, so I'm going to make this real quick. Memorial Day history started in 1863 when some Southern ladies put flowers on graves of Confederates. In 1868, a General Logan made it an annual celebration on the 30th of May. In 1971, the year that myself and Chick Burlingame graduated from Annapolis, they diluted the meaning of this weekend by changing it to accommodate our vacationing mindset in America. And there's a lot of dilution of honor of veterans that's been going on during my lifetime, in fact, going on since 1837. I'm gonna point out that it was my pleasure to fly that airplane for 13 years. 3 years more, I flew the F-16, and I was always looking for the enemies of America with the authority to remove them. Now, as a retiree, an Annapolis graduate, a Marine, an Oath Keeper, and a Christian, I'm going after some bigger fish. And on a global level. I was called to Malaysia to help the nation of Malaysia find out who took their airplane in March. And in today, on Memorial Day, the 26th of May, Malaysia has front page news about what we collectively have exposed. I want to talk about the betrayal of America's enlisted by some of the most senior officers. And I'm going to limit it to three betrayals. My college classmate, Chick Burlingame, who flew F-4s, who is allegedly the captain of an airplane that crashed into the Pentagon on 9/11. It did not, and he did not. I want to recognize Pat Tillman, who died on the 22nd of April of 2004 in what has been recorded as a friendly fire incident. It was not. But mostly I want to talk about a person I never heard of until Thursday of last week when his parents came into my house for 5 hours and said, is there anything you can do to help expose the truth of what happened to our son, Special Operations Chief Aaron Carson Vaughn, United States Navy, who died on a helicopter, and I acknowledge the helicopter pilot behind me. His helicopter was Extortion 17. I will leave no stone unturned, and in accordance with John 10:18, I'm going to die before I'm going to let this memory fade. This man did not die by accident. There's a book in the gift shop called Betrayed. This man was betrayed by some people in our own nation. It's not political, it's not military. Ladies and gentlemen, it's treason, and I don't like using that word, but I'd rather use the word publicly than see one more enlisted man wounded, PTSD'd, or killed. And I wonder if Russia and Malaysia can act on my information, why the United States cannot. And if anybody's fearing for my life, have no fear. Psalm 91:13 and Isaiah 54:17 prove to me in Scripture that my Lord will protect me. God bless America. Amen.